everyone, it's Ben Hardy here, and in today's video, we're going to be going over an Audi SQ5. This one is a 2018, and it's being provided to us by the Dodge Ram here in Sandy, Utah. And just so you guys know, I'm going to include a link to their inventory in the description below, where obviously you can get the most up-to-date pricing on this vehicle, and then you can see a bunch of other stuff, but let's get right into the video. Under the hood of the SQ5, we have a turbocharged 3-liter V6 that does go through an 8-speed automatic transmission. Fuel economy is 19 around town and then 24 on the highway, with power outputs being 354 horsepower and then 369 pound-feet of torque and a 0-60 time of just over 5 seconds. Now let's go over the front end on the SQ5, and I can definitely tell the difference between this and a Q5 just because this looks a little bit more aggressive. I'm noticing that there's a little bit more venting, and even the headlights themselves, they just have that little bit more aggressive look to them. Yes, you get the SQ5 badging right there, but I just overall, I like kind of like the round design, but then also just all the sharp angles this has, because it kind of gives this like beautiful yet like aggressive appeal. Now around the side here, we've got 255mm tires wrapped around 20-inch wheels in the front and in the rear as well. And then you guys will notice you get the little fender fur that goes around. I definitely love that the brakes are painted red. Obviously, that's kind of like a signature of a performance vehicle. They always do the red brake calipers so that you know the car is sporty. You got the V6T there on the side, so you know that it has a V6 and then it's turbocharged. And other than that, here's kind of like your side angle, and you can see that this one does have a roof rack. Now here's a key fob for the SQ5. You guys will notice that it does say S on the back, so you guys know that you got the sportier version. You've got the lock there at the top, you've got the unlock, and then the release for the hatch, which hold that down and it'll pop it right open. Now coming here into the rear, the first thing that I like is you actually can raise or lower the rear, obviously to make it so it's easier to load things into the back. And got this little handle which actually drops down the seat. You guys can see storage space back here is pretty decent. And then you got this little handle which, lifting that up, you guys can see that you can have the spare in there, which I mean is pretty small. 195mm versus the 255s that this has is definitely on the small side. But other than that, there's everything for that part of the back. And then notice that you can lock everything from here and then also lower down the hatch. Now coming here to the side, you can actually use the keyless entry system even here in the back. And you guys will look at the door panel, which I actually really like the fit and finish on the door panel. So you got this kind of like nice body line that continues right here, and the little door handle is kind of hidden in it. And then you do get the Alcantara insert right there with the leather trim here for the back just down below. And then with the seats, they're actually really nice. So it's quilted leather there in the center, which again is a really nice look. In terms of the feel of the leather, definitely like a very soft feel in general, but they still have a sporty look back here. Now I will pop in. So popping in is actually pretty easy. I mean, it is an SUV. I'm 5'11 and I've got a good amount of leg room. Headroom is also solid as well back here. And then you guys will notice that you got some vents back here, and then us can use that to charge a little device. And then this, by the way, is for the climate controls. You do have a climate for the rear. Now pulling this down, you guys will notice that this is kind of like this intricate system just to get a couple of cup holders out. Pretty interesting, but I mean, I'll definitely think about it, and I mean, I'll live with it. Other than that though, that's the back.
I'm not sure if I can get this to do it, but it makes a clicking sound when you lock it sometimes.
Aha, it did it. Hopefully you guys heard that. But anyways, coming up to the front, do have keyless entry, and the mirrors are power folding, as you can see. Now, opening up the door panel here at the front, it's pretty much identical to the one in the rear. So you get the same leather, you get the same Alcantara, all of your window controls, mirror controls. You do get memory seats. I mean, you'd expect that with a luxury car. That actually opens up the hatch. Now the seats here at the front, I really like them just from a design standpoint. They're really comfortable to sit in. You've got really nice bolstering on the seats, and again, that quilted leather. Here's what the power adjustments look like. I actually like the pedal layout. I think the pedals just have like a really nice look to them. They did a good job there. Here's where your light controls are, and then the steering wheel is actually manually adjustable, which is interesting, but yeah, that's all. Now the stop start button here in the SQ5 is actually down there, and it's got a pretty nice sporty look to it. Car makes a little fart when it starts up, which you guys will hear that a little bit more later, but everything will come to life. Here's our steering wheel in the SQ5. I really like the stitching on the inside of the steering wheel. It's kind of like double tiered with the stitching. Hopefully you guys can see the two different layers of stitching right there. This does have the square bottom steering wheel, which definitely has like a different sportier feel to it. You've got your voice commands over here. You can actually do the like little navigation voice command. And then over here on the other side, you got the controls for the center stack. Notice that your cruise control is actually hiding back there on the steering wheel, and it's not attached. So like when you move the steering wheel, it doesn't go with it. You do have the plus and minus paddles as well. And then you got your turn signal on that side, and then also for the high beams. And then over there is your windshield wiper stalk.
Here are the gauges on the SQ5. I actually really like them. So over on the left side, you've got the RPMs. On the right side, you've got the speed. And then you actually have a couple different menus you can scroll through. I like how you can pop the navigation up there in the center. Just cool to have that like front and center. And then notice that you can even zoom in and out on the navigation itself, and you can change your view. So like you can make it so that the navigation is bigger with the screen or smaller, depending on just what you're wanting to see with the screen system. But overall, I like the screen system. I think it's really intuitive, just from like a use standpoint, and I think it just looks really nice as well. Here's our center infotainment system. First off, I'm gonna pop into reverse so you guys can see what the backup camera looks like. Resolution on this is super solid. You guys can see there's a parking sensors in the front and the rear, and you get that kind of like bird's eye view, and it shows you exactly where you're turning when you turn the steering wheel. Overall, I really like the view on the camera. You can actually see really far, which is kind of different. Definitely has a different viewpoint, but that's the camera system. Now, the rest of the infotainment system, it is not a touchscreen, so you gotta use a little dial to go through, and you guys can actually probably hear the dial. But in terms of like going through the different menus, really easy to use. And yes, even though you have the navigation menu in the center screen, you've got one here too, so you could like double up with the navigation menus if you want. Overall, the infotainment system is really easy to use. I would prefer a touchscreen, but I'm completely okay with how this is just because of how easy the infotainment dials are to use. Now down here, you've got the dual zone climate controls. And then, like I said, there is a climate for the rear as well. Heated seats at the front, no air conditioned seats though, sadly. This just turns off the screen. That's your hill descent control, your parking sensors, stability control, auto stop start, drive mode select, which we'll get into in just a moment. You guys saw the engine stop start button before. And then you got a USB and a 12 volt. This is what you do to control the whole infotainment system. So with the dial, and then you got your shortcut buttons as well. So pretty straightforward. They've got quite a few drive modes with the SQ5. You guys can see all the different drive modes. You got the dynamic, individual, and you actually can hear a difference in the exhaust when you go to dynamic. It does open up the valves. You got the comfort all road, and then you've got the lift off road, and that'll actually raise the suspension. Like I said, this does have the suspension in the back that can raise, but it can also raise in the front as well. So then it gives you a little bit better ground clearance. Now the shifter is really easy to use. You just have to slightly push up for neutral, and then you go all the way up for reverse, pretty easy, and then down for drive. And then if you do want to do the manual shifting, you just put it over, and then you can use the paddles, or you can use this little shifter, whichever you prefer. And then you can just press the P for park, it'll go back in. Got the parking brake right there. I actually really like the stitching here on the side, just kind of makes it look a little bit nicer. You can move this back and forth. So you got cup holders, but then you got a tray, which is just different. Center console, which you got a little bit more storage space. You guys notice that you can basically have it at different heights. So wherever you want it, it'll actually stick, which is pretty nice. And then finally, you've got the glove box here, lined with felt, pretty normal size for this size of car. And don't forget, this does have all-wheel drive, so it says Quattro. Up top here, we do have the controls for the panoramic sunroof, and the sunshade kind of lets a little bit of light through, which is pretty nice. Universal garage door openers, and they do a full black headliner, which makes sense because it's kind of like the sporty package, so it goes to the interior, and that's all for up top. Now that we're done going over the interior on the SQ5, let's quickly get into pricing. So, like I said, check their website for the most up-to-date pricing on this particular car. This one's priced in the mid-40s as of me making this video. It's a 2018 with 22,000 miles on the odometer right now. These SQ5s are like the newer ones. Obviously, they're in that like 60, upwards of like $70,000. Depends on the exact options you get, right? Depends on how bespoke you basically make the car. The used ones, obviously, this one's now into the 40s. Some of them are a little bit less if it's an older year and higher mileage. I think overall though, it's really good price for like a performance luxury SUV if you get a used one like this. That all being said, let's take this SQ5 out and see how it drives. Let's talk about visibility before we set off here on the SQ5. So it's really easy to see over the hood. It just goes right down.
There's your visibility through both of the mirrors. And then here's your visibility all throughout the rear. So visibility in general is actually pretty good here in the car, and I kind of expected that. It's an SUV, and it's also kind of like a roundish shape with a bunch of big windows, but let's set off. I'm initially setting off in this Audi SQ5, and the first thing I'm noticing about this car is it's actually really smooth and really quiet. Like, it does a really good job as a luxury car. These seats are incredibly comfortable. Like, these are one of the most comfortable seats that I have sat in a car. Like, the leather just has this like nice like plushness to it. But like I said, they look really cool with like the quilted leather design and the aggressive bolsters and all of that. And the other thing that I noticed right off the bat, steering's extremely light. It kind of feels cool. The steering wheel like just has this like sporty feel to it, which just like the actual like design on it feels sporty in your hands. And other than that, like I said, from the luxury car perspective, it does a really good job. It's smooth, it's quiet. You don't hear a whole lot from the engine in this comfort mode. You hear a little bit when you're under throttle, and like I said, not a whole lot. And as we get up here, obviously we'll be able to talk about how, like, the minor acceleration aspect of it, but the handling there is actually really good. Like, this actually handles relatively flat for an SUV. Now, it's not a sports car by any means, but like I said, it is relatively flat for an SUV. And coming here for our minor acceleration, its gear shifts are quick. It actually gets into it pretty quickly. But now we're going to obviously switch over into our dynamic mode, go over to the manual mode, and well, we're gonna see what she's made of. Oh, those downshifts. I like the downshifts, like just how responsive they are, but then the little gargles that the exhaust makes. And I'm told that when I do an acceleration, it's gonna make some farting noises, so be prepared for the farting noises. Oh, it's quick. It is rightfully quick. That is actually like, it's quicker than I thought it would be. I read low 5 second range and I go, okay, well, that's about as quick as my Raptor, which is a big truck. It feels quicker than that though. It actually does, like it has really just like quick response time. Now the pedal does have double actuation on it. You press it in and then it'll kind of go, and then you press it in and there's another little like pedal actuation on it that you press in further, and then that's what really gets you going. But yeah, the turbo lag, it's noticeable, but it's not crazy, and it does make the little fart noises. It goes like, and you guys heard that when I was doing the exhaust clip. And yeah, those downshifts, those are really nice. Like, they're just quick, like just boom, boom, boom. Yeah, I love the sound of that exhaust, actually. It's just cool with the little fart noises. Let's get into summing things up, though, with this SQ5. I think that, especially, like I said, used, it's such a good value. It's a really fun performance SUV, and you get all this luxury equipment, and you get, you know, obviously the performance acceleration that this has and everything at what I would consider a pretty good value. The average new car is about $38,000, and this used with 22,000 miles, which is nothing, 2018, so pretty close to brand new, being pretty close to the price of the average new car, and getting all this luxury feature, getting an SUV, getting the performance, all that, I think it's a really good, like, I just think it's a good offer. So yeah, if you're in the market for an SUV like that, check out a used SQ5 like this one. And there we have it, everyone, this Audi SQ5. And again, a huge shout out and thank you to the Dodge Ram here in Sandy for providing us with this Audi SQ5. Check out their inventory in the link below. I will see all of you in that next video.